Can you say a better argument would have said there's cards in the boxes?
Well, we can still make that argument. It's not like it's over. Right?
Are there cards in the boxes?
That's my argument.
Were there puzzle boxes, though?
Like some of the boxes have cards in them. Not all of them.
So it was, it was a continuous stream of cards, then.
I don't know if both stacks had a box set with cards.
Also, on the topic of arguments, I just think that it's funny that most of the times that we have these tests where there's like some leverage, the people kind of go ahead, and then afterwards, like in this duo, we're like, oh, that was stupid. The entire time we were filming, it was you two arguing. Like David was actively like, this does not make sense, and you were full steam ahead.
I do also want to argue that since you say that the bottom card is your house, if you don't count the puzzle boxes as part of that house, and it's just the bottom card, those were really flat cards, and Cole's cards were kind of bent, so they're a little taller, just a little bit.
I was tempted to give Ian's mom some points after causing Ian to get the...
She wasn't causing me to get anything. I just was bored.
She was the infidus.
Okay,
the
Ian would not like his mom to get a point.
Okay.
Get out of here.
No points for Ian's mom.
She is in the audience.
I think she deserves a point for that.
Okay. You know what? For being Taskmaster here in the audience, is. 1 point.
One point. Woo!
What was your reason for choosing darts?
Darts are the game. Darts is a game for the upper class.
Eric, hit it with a golf club.
I like that.
Well, I mean, it was kind of buffering there at the beginning, but yeah. my whole idea was, how can you elegantly approach it rather than, or make it ring basically rather than elegantly touching it directly.
Okay.
So I kind of dressed up. I did this very similar thing as you with the drink.
Yeah.
And so it you didn't see it because it was buffering, but when I actually lifted up the golf club, I lifted it up in one motion. And so up,
how elegant!
It was very smoothly.
It was a very elegant motion. Everything was very elegant
that
in motion.
That would have changed everything.
I feel like I was shafted a little there with the buffering at the beginning.
Shafted with your motion of the shaft.
Yeah.
Jackson, like ritual of the flower stick.
Thank you.
I wasn't expecting this. He didn't tell me there was going to be a spin involved. That took me by surprise.
Yeah. If I can also say, apparently on that day when I was doing that task, it was the most mosquitoes Minnesota has like ever seen. It was like some crazy statistic like that. So being out there for like over 50 minutes, being absolutely swarmed by mosquitoes, like I was bitten like at least 50 times.
Yeah. Why was Cole indoors?
Yeah.
So Cole and Jackson both did this task indoors because it was raining outside. Yeah. So didn't want the books to get dirty.
Okay, all right. Oh, those precedents over mosquitoes.
It was a nightmare.
To be fair, there's mosquitoes inside too. So. Ian also had kind of figured it out. I don't think he ever actually figured it out.
Not during the task.
But
like Goodnight Moon was a complete.
Yeah, you got so lucky that the last book was Goodnight Moon and your last letter was G. That was complete luck. You sort of figured out something to do with the alphabet, but you thought it had to be attached to the numbers because on book 21. You figured out like, oh, there's something about the alphabet. The 21st letter is U, so then you guessed 15 things that started with U.
David, how long did it take me to make my first guess? Because I remember it took me a long
not that long to take a first guess compared to some other people. Cole took 5 minutes, for instance, to make his first guess. Actually, I was about to bring this up. Jackson took 25 minutes before his first... Well, okay, Jackson figured out the solution less than a minute into the task and then took 25 minutes before his first guess.
So
yeah,
was there like a metal sphere while like David was lying on the couch?
Oh, that was a lamp.
Yeah, that was a lamp.
That's the second time we've had somebody not recognize a lamp.
It was an air horn guy.
Both times.
He has never heard of a lamp.
All right. Can we have another task, please?
Yes. Our next task is not going to be in the final episode of today's episode. I wanted to cut this task from the show, but Parker said, this one balls so fucking hard, David. I beg of you to not cut this task. So, as a compromise, I'm showing it in the studio today, but it is not going to be in the episode, so you do not need to score this one.
Hey, David.
Hello.
Wow.
Hi, Jackson. Hi, Parker.
Hello.
Hi, David.
Hey, David.
Hi, Bree.
Hello.
Hi, Eric.
David, you're looking pretty jazzy today.
All right.
Here we are. Hopefully for this task, we will be instructed to rack up as many felonies as possible within 1 hour. Then I will have already won. Make a short film that has all the following things.
Dialogue from at least 3 characters. At least 3 props.
A conflict over an absurd problem. An ending where at least one character shouts something into the sky.
Best film wins. Your 30 minutes of your time starts now.
Okay.
We can do that.
Yeah, no problem.
What's the hero's journey that we're gonna go with?
Oh.
There's got to be the problem.
And they have to argue over
it. They got
to
have motives, yeah.
Yeah, okay.
They should kiss a little bit. Okay, cool.
It is Pride Month. Or wait, no, it's not. Fuck. God damn it, that sucks.
So the premise of the task is they had to make a short film, which they did. And then they came back and this happened.
Hello.
Hi, Jackson.
David.
Hi.
Hi, Parker.
How's it going?
All right, good.
Redub.
Oh, this is gonna be fun.
Redub all the dialogue and sound effects from the short film.
That's new short film wins. You have 20 minutes, your time starts now.
You have 20 minutes, your time starts.
Oh, I like the sound of that.
Yeah, this is delightful. I'm enticed and excited.
All right, what do we got?
Okay, so is he spreading canola oil over him? What the hell?
What do you guys think of the film?
I have absolutely no idea what I just watched.
C-.
So this is a really interesting concept for a task. Two teams were working together. So every short film was produced by 4 people. So one team would make a film. I then removed all the audio from it. And then another team had to redub that audio. And then you're going to rank the films originally based on quality. And then whichever team was in the best 2 films would get the first place. First and last would get second place. And then the bottom 2 films would get there. That's how it's supposed to work. The problem was the films were just terrible. They were just so bad. I just cannot put this in the episode. But we're going to watch them. Our first film we're going to watch is Jackson and Parker's films, redubbed by Bree and Eric. So here it is.
I could smell it around here somewhere. Have you seen him? There's someone. Someone has olive oil over here. Someone does.
What? It's you.
What?
Sam? Sam? What?
I smell it. I smell it. It's you. It has to be you.
What are you doing?
You're the one. You're the one with the olive oil. I know you do. You don't even lie to me.
What? No.
Yeah, you just gotta like show it to me. I know you have it.
No.
I won't hurt you.
I don't know what you're talking about. I don't have any olive oil. I hate olive oil. It's this
guy just kind of started appearing and he said he wanted my olive oil, but I really like my olive oil. I'm not giving it to him.
Perfect. That's perfect. That's absolutely perfect. Okay.
Hold on, fellas. I mean, I don't really get what's going on here, but I think I have the perfect solution to your conflict here.
Hi, I'm a bungalow dumper, and I honestly just saw them having a serious conflict, but I thought, you know what? Canola oil seems to be the real solution to their problems. Olive oil, it kind of sucks. Oh, I love this thing.
See, it's just a
Canola oil sucks. Like, everyone knows you can't use canola oil.
It's the best. It's the best.
No, come here. Give me that stuff. You gotta throw it away in the garbage.
No. Oh, I'm finally gone. I can drink this in. Oh, God, I love this canola oil.
Oh, come back. You're gonna. Wait, I smell it. I smell the olive oil.
What?
Oh, there it is. I see it.
What are you doing?
You have it. No. Give it to me. Oh,
What the hell is that?
You're not listening to me earlier.
No, please, no!
No, just watch the olive oil! Give it to me! No one ever gives me my olive oil! Okay. Well, alright. Justice has been served. What would you do for Kirkland's olive oil? Die for it? I don't know, I would.
Okay, that's good. That's good.
Okay. I think this could be the greatest film ever.
I was worried that you guys wouldn't like understand what was going on, but you guys actually kind of captured the plot of it pretty well.
That was essentially the plot of it.
Yeah, you guys did really well, surprisingly.
Marie, please, please start voice acting for me in real life.
That was perfect.
I felt like I was doing a really good job coming over you in this area.
No, I was. That was terrible for me.
And then there's the one scene in the middle that you just forgot to voice. There's just nothing there.
We got contempt with it.
That's fine. It's fine.
Oh my God. Okay.
I could smell it.
That was so good. I don't know what you're talking about, David.
That was phenomenal.
That was really good. David, can you send it?
The bar is up here. Okay.
Okay.
The bar has been set very high.
All right. Next up is Ian and Cole's film, which has been redubbed by Jackson and Parker, and this one requires so much explanation.
No explanation.
You want to explain it after?
First of all, Jackson and Parker provided their own musical backing to this film, which is just consisting of Parker moaning. They made the creative decision that Ian had a soft-boiled egg stuck in his throat throughout the filming, so he can only make guttural growling noises.
That actually did happen. That was okay. I don't know how you knew that.
They requested that I add a Vine boom sound effect every time any two things touched on screen. They decided that this film takes place in an alternate reality where when liquids pour, it makes the sound of people faintly whispering secrets. And finally, they switch roles halfway through because they forgot who was voicing Ian and who was voicing Joel. So, here it is.
This is Ian's internal monologue. Oh yeah, I have a soft-boiled egg in the back of my throat, but I'm not gonna swallow it. Oh. Oh. My friend, have you smelled an egg by chance?
You made me swallow my egg! I'll kill you!
Oh my God.
What?
Oh my God.
What do you mean?
Oh my god!
That doesn't tell me anything!
Fair point.
Fuck!
What an unfortunate series of events. Let's go get some ice cream to forget about the whole thing, friend. How do you say?
You said it, pal. We dubbed the video. No problem, David. It was an honor.
I mean, like, yeah, I kind of just want to do this. Like, I just want to do this on my own. It seems so much fun.
It was awesome. It was a lot of fun.
You said it, pal. That's going on the Taskmaster MN merch. You said it, pal.
That's the new also, break that.
One thing David did leave out, some of the background noise was we did just stick one of the microphones right up next to the microwave and just let it run for a while.
I was wondering what that was.
It was just a microwave sound.
Oh, God. Okay. All right. Finally, we've got Bree and Eric's film voiced by Ian and Cole.
Did he tell you anything about our dub?
Me?
Yeah, you.
I was there.
Oh, you were there, right?
Yeah.
you know how fast he came up with the topic.
Right? Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah.
Instant. It was instant. This film. I had no creative input besides like how we did it. He was just like, "We're doing this."
This film would best be described as Ender's Game meets the Communist Manifesto.
Angles.
Hey, Marks. What's up? What'd you bring?
I brought the new edition of Down with the Bourgeoisie for Nintendo Switch, where you can act out killing the bourgeoisie in real time.
That does not look like the script to our Communist Manifesto.
Well, yeah, but I also brought you a shot, so let's get wasted and get going.
But right for in the time for our live show, you can hear them.
Well, look, they can wait. Now's the time to just play our game, inspire the people.
They're waiting for us to tell them about communism.
Okay, well, we'll show them about communism. Hell, don't show. We'll show them about what needs to be done.
We better be doing this right.
Don't worry. This game's great. You're gonna love it. We're just gonna sit down, we're gonna kill the bourgeoisie virtually.
All right, well, I better get my microphone ready. All right, everybody. We are playing a new game, Down with the Bourgeoisie, live for you on twitch.tv/marksandangles. Here we go! Oh wow, these graphics are really realistic.
Yeah, just jam that shoot button and make sure that the blood sprays everywhere. You gotta get all of them.
It really makes you think you're shooting the White House.
Yeah, well, that's just the first capital.
Wow, okay. Well, you know, it says, you know, success, mission one. Yeah, yes. You sure
that
you did?
Yes, you thought it was a game, but actually you were controlling the death bots.
What? What are you talking about?
This is all real life, the boots are dead.
Why?
I feel like that really got our message across.
Yeah.
I feel like it doesn't really matter whether we win the task because we're going for the Oscars.
What the
fuck? The depths of Cole's creative mind.
The fact that he came up with that just instantly?
He was like, we're going to do something about communism. I was like,
he just had that on deck.
I think the main reason we should probably cut this task is the thinly veiled threats against the United States.
But he got a match, so yeah. I would consider that.
Using the power company van as the most stylish car.
Pretty impressive.
He's onto something.
Like a union, or... I don't know, is there some reason? I don't know.
I have no idea why he picked the power company van. Yeah, the weird thing is right behind it was like a Rolls Royce, but yeah.
You didn't consider hitting it with any force.
Well, when I did hit it with force, it went out less far. We did see that.
Oh.
It might have been a different condition in the bottle from whatever.
Yeah, that's it.
Did you try adding more force?
No, I figured adding more force would just...
What I saw when you press it really hard is you press it really hard, but just kind of slow. You're like... Something like that.
Yeah.
Well, I didn't want to hurt the bottle.
Yeah. The alignment of the stars and the atmospheric conditions.
Okay.
I did look it up. The next day, if I had the stars would have aligned just right.
Yeah, okay. The moon was pulling on the earth and pulling your soap down. Yeah.
One other quote I enjoyed from him was inside the tissue box, the things he put in there was a bunch of playing cards and then also the box that the playing cards came from. And then he said, he described that situation as having been equalized with, he described the cards as having been equalized with what was previously their greater in a Milton-esque Paradise Lost situation.
Quite surprising.
Can you explain that for me? Can you explain that to me? Like in layman's terms.
If any of you ever need to explain who Cole is, I think show them this clip.
It's like you change one thing, and I think that's why Parker had an advantage. Yeah. You've probably been up there the most.
I've been in that area, sifting around.
Chaos. He knows there's not always that Italian flag on the couch, which Cole needed a hint to find.
You could never tell what was added or taken away because there was just so much crap.
I'd also like to say that at least I could draw the Italian flag from memory, you know, instead of not knowing what the Italian flag was.
I didn't want to be crucified.
The great Steve Deception.
You killed an innocent balloon.
Yeah, I think that's...
I mean, they were all innocent.
You got what was coming in.
So if you win, you can be just like Eric. There you go.
If I win, I will commit to a 5-year plan of sticking as many of those to Eric as possible.
You know what? In solidarity.
That's how I'm feeling right now.
laughing while crying emoji. Yeah.
Does that embody your feelings?
Yeah, this is how I feel. Right now.
Good.
Whenever I feel like this, I'm not going to do it. I'm just going to point.
That's going to save time. That's going to save time and effort.
I'm all about the seconds.
Yeah. Feeling Eric.
Who thought of that one? Did you think of that one, David?
I did, yeah. Uh-huh. Yeah, okay, this is true, actually. This is interesting. That was originally going to be for Jackson. And then after we filmed the fall test, because I was like, okay, I got to give that one to Eric.
What? Persuaded you specifically?
Just your overall behavior.
Your conduct.
That was one of the first tasks that we filmed at all this season. I was just like, oh my god, what have I got myself into with this guy? I was not expecting that from Eric based on what I knew of you at the time.
That was crazy.
Well, that's another thing you learned from him.
That's true.
To fear Eric.
Funny because... Yeah, like that. You said that was one of the first tasks. I thought it was one of the last, considering how mad Eric was at David.
That was like the second one.
He hadn't even done anything to you yet.
Yeah, wait, why did he become more polite as the season went on?
I don't know if he did. I mean, because one of the last tasks we filmed was the balloon one with look in the mirror, look how stupid you are.
In all fairness, that was after the books task.
Yeah.
I was just so done with that entire day.
So the deal is, I can only pick it up, I can't move with it?
Correct, yeah, you can only...
Pick it up and throw it. But every throw exponentially cuts down on my...
I moved it. Yeah.
I wish we'd had a camera filming us measuring Jackson's frisbee because we had one person on the dock with one end of the tape measure, and we threw the tape measure into someone in a boat, and then had to like drift around and try to be where the frisbee was.
Behind my childhood house was a marsh, and I would get it stuck in the marsh every time we played frisbee. So this is not surprising.
Oh, yeah. Okay. Wait, you've played frisbee before?
When did we film that?
I'm excited for it.
Okay.
So, summer 2021.
Oh my gosh.
Do you think like the... Where were you during that?
Just storm drain.
Yeah, storm
drain. We crawled our way in there.
Do you think the storm drain will still be there? in 100 years?
One can hope.
God, I hope I'm dead before I'm 100.
Doesn't seem like a very strong tradition, if you ask me.
Well, it's a brand new one. It hasn't taken hold yet.
Also, okay, Mr. Water Drinker, whatever, man.
We should have did it multiple times.
This is like a cultish, like weird. It reminds me of that experiment where they shocked monkeys if they got a banana, and then monkeys were afraid of bananas for generations.
That's actually similar to the origins of this tradition, actually.
It's highly experiential. You have to kind of be there. It's like you're getting some Gnostic knowledge.
I don't want to be there.
It's not a spoken tradition. It's just like innate. Yeah, it lived. It's an innately understood tradition. You can't explain it to somebody. They just have to participate, and then they'll know.
Yeah. Okay, well, I guess I will never know.
That's unfortunate.
The last one, please.
I'll say that was definitely the most genuinely irritated I was through the whole season. I was quite mad at Parker. Okay.